shit just got real.
Michael Bay is a pretty big deal. A director with a style instantly identifiable, even by the normie-ist of filmgoers. A reckless tangle of pixel-fucking CGI, vrooming cameras and ADHD editing, all together forming something that is subjectively dynamic and epic. This odd mix has made him one of the biggest directors in Hollywood, but not the most critically acclaimed. Megadirectors don't just render into existence. They need to start somewhere, and Bay comes from the same place that Spike Jones, Michel Gondry, and David Fincher were spawned. MTV. Bay initially made his name with a Donny Osmond relaunch video, before moving on to making notable videos for Divinyl's and Vanilla Ice's But his music video high point was for Meatloaf's I Do Anything For Love, But I Won't Do That. This was a video with an actual budget. Helicopters, war exploding motorbikes, and something alike to an actual narrative. It's over 7 minutes long, epic and dynamic in all the ways that Bay would soon make his own. So what makes Anything For Love so Bay? Straight off, there's a lot less giant fighting robots, so not a good start for comparison. But helpfully, the essence of the video is sexy Beauty and the Beast with motorbike helicopter chases, which helps ramp up this ballad to Bay levels. Motorbikes have been a Meatloaf staple since day one, but Bay doesn't film the bike like he does cars now, as aspirational objects. The bike here represents escape, in the same way it has done for Meatloaf since Bat Out of Hell. Symbolism in a Bay project? You're goddamn right. Needless sex appeal is Bay's bread and butter, as can be seen in pretty much everything he's directed. His women are often nothing but sexualized props to momentarily distract from the CGI onslaught, shot in a way to emphasize the TNA. Anything For Love has this in spades, not just with the lingering shots of the beauty surrogate, but also more explicitly in the unexplained lesbian vampires that caress and lick beauty for no good reason, apart from because Mr. Bay said so. Classic. Anything For Love has approximately 320 cuts within its 7 minute plus runtime, giving an average shot length of 1.3 seconds. This is actually even more rapid than he manages today, Transformers having an ASL of 3 seconds. Films simply being longer than music videos cannot keep that higher pace. Too many cuts for too long creates information overload, but Bay's ASL is half the rate of Spielberg, and a touch faster than Nolan. There are moments in the video where Anything For Love visually references Fincher's work on Aerosmith's Janie's Got a Gun. Both are adept technical directors, but Fincher's technique has purpose to its usage. While Bay's technical skills only extend to making everything look dynamic and epic all the time. Bay has not shown a Fincher influence since. The original treatment for the video was actually dreamt up by David Fincher, but a disagreement over money stopped Fincher from directing the video himself. In the book, I Want My MTV, the uncensored story of the music video revolution, Meatloaf recalls.
He gave me a budget of 1.7 million. I said, David, we don't have that kind of money. And Fincher said, well then, get Michael Bay. That's the last time Michael Bay was the cheaper option.
The video was eventually made with Bay for a mere $750,000, and it kickstarted his career. After Anything For Love, Bay directed two more overblown, sexed up Meatloaf videos, with one featuring a young Angelina Jolie. Next came Bad Boys, and his rise, for better or worse, has continued unabated ever since. Thanks, Meatloaf. Thanks a lot.